guys, and welcome to Knitgrit. In today's video, we're going to go over, this is part two of my octopus slash jellyfish amigurumi. So in the last video, I showed you how to make the body of this cute little amigurumi octopus. And in this video, I'm going to show you how I do these quick little tendrils on the very end and how I get them to curl on the bottom. So I have a pattern for this. It's on my Ravelry. I've got it right here. Actually, this is the PDF that I had created and I put on my Ravelry account. So if you want to download that, that's going to be right down in the doobly-doo. So you can go check it out down there. I'm going to have it lying right here so that I can remember exactly what I did, because even I forget occasionally what I've done. It's been a little bit because I've been working on these cute little amigurumi dolls that I'm doing for my Ravelry and my Etsy called Luna Dolls. And I've been working on these adorable little sweaters. I'm thinking I'm going to sell the pattern for this, but I was wondering that I've kind of mentioned it a couple times in a couple of my other videos, if people would be interested in me posting on here, just because I get paid through advertisements on here, so it's not like it's kind of like a give and take. The pattern would be for sale, but I would have it for free on my YouTube because I get paid AdSense money. So if you're interested in that, post down below if you're interested in that kind of thing. Also, I have a Patreon account now, which actually, if you become a patron, you get a free pattern depending on which tier you're on. Some of them are random, some of them are, hey, you can pick a specific pattern and it is for free. So go check that out down in the description below. All right, without further ado and without further plugging myself, I'm going to get to the actual pattern. All right. So to do this, all I'm doing is taking the color that I want to do. This guy didn't have a little different color here, so I'm going to just pick blue because there are blue specks in there. And I know I'm chatty, but there's patterns on Ravelry for a reason if you don't want to hear me chat and talk and go through my reasoning and my processes. So I take my yarn right here and I push it into just the farthest part, like over here. I'm going to do two repetitions of the short tendril, which is what I'm doing with the color. I'm doing a short tendril version of it. Right here, that's the first part that's listed. I'm going to go into the side. That's a little bit too in. So I'm gonna go here, and on the other side, this is where I'm gonna go in for the opposite side. I'll show you in just a moment. And you don't have to go in the way that I'm going in. You can just chain 20 and then do all this on its own and then sew it on. I find that this is just easier. And I also just like how it looks better. I leave a decently long tail. That way I can go back and make sure that all of these, if you notice, I just keep the strings on there because those act as little mini tendrils. I then cut them all the same length. That way it's not, you know, sloppy looking. So I'm going to slip this through like so, and I'm going to chain, for my short tendrils, I'm going to chain 20. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So I've done 20 right there. Now I'm going to start single crocheting one into each stitch until I get back to the very beginning. So I'm going to single crochet all of these. I like to skip the first chain from my hook. So technically it's only like 19 single crochets down across the entire thing. So I'm going off camera. So I'm going to skip this first one and go right into the second chain from my hook and do a quick little single crochet. You'll notice that with my single crochet, just like in the very first part of the tutorial, I tend to pull with the left, going from left to right instead of left right to left. That's just because I like how the stitch looks better that way. It is purposeful. I'm not a weirdo. Well, I am, but that's not the reason why. So you're gonna put one in each one of these stitches. Counting isn't super important, honestly. You just want to make sure they're both the same length. Yeah, so we're not doing any kind of fun curling for this. It kind of just kind of curls on its own, and you're just going to keep going with your single crochet all the way to the beginning. Be right back. All right, so now I've gotten to the very last stitch, so I'm going to single crochet into that first chain that you made very originally over there. And now I'm going to go back inside of what I slip stitched into originally. So I'm going to go back in here and I'm going to slip stitch very carefully and do a quick little chain, because I think that that kind of cements it, and I make a nice long tail and I pull through and then I pull it nice and taut. So here I'm going to leave those tails for now because I'm going to cut them all the same length at the very end, and I find that that's easiest so I don't keep wasting yarn and making my tails even shorter and shorter and shorter. So I'm going to repeat what I just did there for the short tendrils. I like how these are the short tendrils, but the other one ends up becoming longer. Just, it works out, I promise, just because of the way the things are. Here, we're going to go back across. And I'm going to go into, like, the stitch across that way. It's kind of just a guessing game. There's no real, like, technique other than just make it even and try to make it look as smooth as you can going across. So I'm going to do that, and then I'll be right back. Okay, so now we are going to work on the long tendrils. We just finished with our short tendrils, and for the long tendrils, we are going to chain 30. This time it's 10 chains longer, and with that extra 10, we're going to do this kind of, like if you look here, it looks like it kind of curls on the bottom, so they're longer, but they're also not that much longer considering how much these stitches will bunch up. So I'm going to place 3 single crochet inside each of the first 10 chains from my hook. I again am going to skip the very first chain, and I'm going to put the 3 inside of this. Let me see if I can get this to focus. There we go! I did it! Alright, we put 3, 1, same chain, 2, going back, you'll notice that it kind of looks a little bit big now, 3. So I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to go into the next one, which is the next ridge afterwards, and we're going to do 1, 2, 3. Again, so that's the second stitch we've done that in. We're going to the third, 1, 2, 3, going into the fourth stitch, 1, oh, unless you split your yarn and then things get interesting. There we go, 1, 2, 3. What kind of knit grit video is it if you don't split your yarn at least 5 times? Fifth one, so 1, 2, 3. Sixth stitch here now. 1, 2, 3. In the same 6th chain. Going into the 7th chain now. 1, 2, 3. Going into the 8th chain now. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, and finally, we're going into our 10th stitch here. If I can find it, there we go. There it is. Can be a little weird when you start doing multiple single crochets inside of one chain. So that's 3 inside that. And so for the rest of these, you're going to just try to keep your chain straight and go into it and not twist your chain around. And you're going to single crochet down the rest of that chain. I will be right back. And all you do is slip stitch the same, and then you repeat on the other side of this. That's really all there is to it. I'll show you how I cut the tail so that they're all matching once I'm done with those 2. Be right back. Okay, so now that I've got all my legs done, I'm going to try to get all of my tails, basically pull on them all the same length. So I'm going to pull this here, try to keep it as taut as I can, and then I'm going to cut my tails so that they are all the same length. I'm holding them all so that they are pinched all the same length, and I'm going to just cut right across. I did a lot of waste, probably shouldn't have done that. I was being not so great about my length. But now, that's all there is to my little guy here. He is all done. So if you're interested in this kind of video, hit like, do all the social media, good YouTube things. You know how to do it. I'm going to be posting more videos. I have a knit crate coming soon, so I'm going to be posting that. I actually have a question. For my videos, I've got these two planned. Which one do people think I should do first? This one's a little manta ray. He's pretty cute with a little underbelly. He's very similar to my whale, which seems to be doing really well. I don't know why, but he is. So I've got a little manta ray guy dude coming here, and then I've also got a cactus. I'm leaning towards the cactus, but I kind of want to know what people think. Be sure to follow all of our social media, as I said before. And if you're actually interested in how I make this doll sweater, let me know, because if there's actually interest in this, then I actually will post it to YouTube, because they're actually fairly simple for as far as design goes, and I'd really like to do something like that for my channel. Alright, until next time, guys. Bye. Here we go.